back in the house of the Lord. Amen. I love to come and hear what he's doing for him. Amen.
Amen.
All right. As the choir comes, let's give us a hymn. We'll turn to page 13. We'll sing the first and the last. Page 13. Stand up for Jesus. Amen. As the choir comes, let's all stand this morning and sing. Page 13, first and the last. I would play the piano, but I know your ears are sensitive this morning, so I'll just leave that to Christine when she gets here next Sunday. All right, everybody ready? Here we go. Stand up for Jesus, ye soldiers of the cross. Live by his royal banner, it must not suffer loss. From victory unto victory, his army shall he lead. See, every foe is vanquished, and Christ is Lord indeed. Stand up for Jesus, the strife will not be long. This day the noise of great song. Just enjoy it. Amen. Think about the words. Amen. This is an awesome song. Christine, you to lead us on this, but she's having some plans she's got to do this morning. So we appreciate her. I'm just going to fill in for her. I don't sound as good as she does, but I don't do as good as she does. God, remember this song of thanks. Here we go.
Jesus, my Savior, Lord, there is none like you.
Amen. That's right.
All of my days, I want to praise the wonders of your mighty love.
Thank you, Lord. Amen.
My comfort, tower of refuge and strength, let every breath, all that I am, never cease to worship you.
Amen.
Shout to the Lord, all the earth let us sing, power and majesty, praise to the King. Of your name.
Let's trust him and obey him. Walk with him, live for him. It'll soon be over, brother.
Amen.
Amen. Glory to God. Let's all stand this morning. Amen.
Amen.
We ain't been since Thursday.
Yeah, we ain't done that work that we did.
I got it.
We can have a work that we did.
Do it?
Yeah.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
He talked over here, and I'll be brief about this. I want to hear from the Lord, what Gary got, and I want to hear the saying. In Matthew chapter 7, Jesus said this: "Beware of false prophets, which come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly they are raging wolves." Amen. Here's where we look at the verse of Scripture a lot of times that we kind of use a little bit. "Ye shall know them by their fruits." He's talking about the false prophets. See, when you're with Jesus Christ and you're learning from Him,
yeah,
He will always give you the truth. He'll give you His wisdom and knowledge and discernment to know. So we have to pray. A lot of times when we pray, we need to say, "God, if this is not of you, you drive this up and wither it away.
Amen.
But if it's of you, you bless it and bring forth for your glory." That's a safe way to pray. Amen on that.
Amen.
So you shall know them by the fruits. This says, "Do men gather grapes and thorns and thistles?" And that's a very sticky thing. That thing hurts. Amen?
Yeah.
"Even so, a good tree bringeth forth good fruit, but a corrupt tree bringeth forth evil fruit." So he's telling you again right there, you shall know them by the fruits. Yeah. You'll know a Christian, you'll know the truth of God by what comes out. It does not contradict the Word of God. God is in that. God's guiding that. God gives you peace about that. Amen? But the things that are coming on the internet today, Becky showed me the other day, one world church is getting together. They're doing it very nonchalantly, and that means this, very unnoticeably. It's becoming entertainment and more than any kind of worship. Okay, they're worshiping something, but not worshiping God. Sorry. But that's, if you go and look at it, and you know the truth will set you free. You'll see the truth. Amen. Mm-hmm. But the people are out there, and they can entice us through the internet. They can entice us through conversation together. And I'm glad that we have a church. And the reason I'm getting up here and saying this, God wants us to do this.
pray that we will stay together in this church in truth, amen, God's truth, in the unity of Christ. Slacks brought that in this morning. Our brother back there, Carl, brought that to me. So, you know, if we stay together, because we are living in perilous times, we are living in the last days. So don't be deceived. Learn the Word of God. Come to church. Hear the preaching. Come to Sunday school. And there's good stuff for us. Read the Word of God every day. You know, so Roger, I'll read my Bible every day. Open your Bible and say, God, just give me something that you need me to have. Sometimes it's just one verse of Scripture. And He brings it to our mind. He said He would do this. I will send the Holy Spirit to those that are born again to come. And He will teach you all things and bring all things into your remembrance, which I have told you. So He won't guide you the wrong way. But listen to this. Good and evil, know the fruit. A good tree will not bring evil fruit.
Sure.
It'll bring good fruit. But a corrupt tree will bring bad fruit. Know the difference. I love you, church. I appreciate
Amen.
You. I didn't get around to shake hands. I apologize. Come on. Sister, sing to us. Yes, ma'am. We say our singers. Amen. Appreciate you, church. I love you.
Roger asked me to sing this again, so it's a little rough, but we'll go with it.
And the
rest of all.
Do you ever find yourself asking God where He's been? Ever get up out of bed saying I can't do this again? Have you ever been afraid of what tomorrow's gonna bring? And you're facing it alone, at least that's what you think. I can tell you after going through that valley, even though I couldn't see it at the time, it was in my weakest moments that He held me.
Yeah.
And I know you'll find me with care when you can't go on. You'll be your strength when your strength is gone. He will lift you up. He will be enough to get you through. Just to watch it disappear. When somebody that you love turns and walks away, and they leave you standing there with a shadow. You don't have to pick up all the broken pieces. You don't have to try to cover up the scars. You are loved and you can always run to Jesus. Just as you are, He will care for you when you can't go on. He'll be your strength when your strength is gone. He will lift you up. He will be enough to get you through. When the road is long and you want to quit, but you think you've got nothing left to give, you can fall to get you through. Yeah. Make all the things wrong that you want to quit.
That's right.
I haven't seen this song in a long time. But I always say it's one of the dearest songs to my heart. It's because it describes my life in a lot of ways. I know a lot of us get tired and we've got problems in our lives and we've got health problems and, you know, some days I have, when we have a lot to do, and I do this myself, I say, I find myself saying, God, I've done enough. And I list them in my head. I say, well, I've done this, and I've done this, and I've done this. And he corrects me real quick.
Amen.
And he says, but it's not enough.
Amen.
And I think of him on that cross.
Yep, that's right.
And he chastises us in different ways.
Mm-hmm.
This morning was one of those mornings for me. He put it all into perspective for me really quick.
Amen. Praise God.
And I just want to tell him how much I love him.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
And I want to thank him. Because he's so good to me.
Yes.
In the time that you gave me, did I give all I could give? Did I love all I could love? Did I live all I could live?
Yes.
Was my faith in your grace strong enough to save me? Did I do all I could do in the time that you gave me? In the time that you gave me, did I face the devil down? Did I make him turn away every time I stood my ground? If today is the day you should decide to take me, did I do all I could do in the time that you gave me? Oh, and I'll never know when it's over. On your shoulders,
yeah.
I might have strayed from the path, I might have gone a little crazy. I'd like to thank God that you cried in the time that you gave me.
Amen.
Yeah. We've all gone a little crazy somehow, right?
Yeah.
But He forgives us and He loves us.
Yeah, brother, go ahead.
Go ahead, just go get his jacket. his word to see. I meant that all.
Amen.
I can't remember what the preacher said. I can't remember what we prayed. But we know one thing, I asked the Lord for my heart. And he did.
Amen.
I want you to know, I've never been saved.
Amen. Praise God. That's right.
I'm glad. So happy. And my kids never seen me pray. Never heard me cut. Never seen me. But I'm saved. And I hear people say all the time, I can't quit doing this, I can't quit doing that, because that's the Lord. Okay, so when I got up at all that night, I was very encouraged.
Amen.
Yep.
The desires of this world is still hard. Please. A lot of people. But you can't say that I'm going to do it because I've always done it. God can clean you up.
That's right.
Amen.
The devil makes you think he can clean you up from the outside. It's got to be from the inside.
Yep, amen.
I don't know how many more years I got left.
Blessing Jesus.
But I want to be what he wants me to be.
Yeah.
Amen.
You pray for me.
Amen. Somebody else. Amen. Maybe the Lord's tugging on your heart. Amen. Amen. You just want to praise him. Amen. You want to worship him.
He's worthy.
Amen. Yes, he is. Amen, Jody. Praise the Lord.
That's good.
He's a merciful God, ain't he? Amen.
Yeah.
Yes, he is. Amen. Feels a little unusual in here this morning. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. All right.
I'm filled with this opportunity to raise my Savior.
Amen.
It's been so good to me. My family worship all for saving me. And Michelle sung that song. I couldn't help myself think about all the times I ran to the Lord. Yeah, he always had his arms out, pulled me through a lot of situations I didn't think I could go through.
Yeah.
And he bring me through them every time. I serve a worthy Savior.
Amen.
He's awesome. He's Alpha and Omega, the beginning, the end. He'll be with me to the day I die. And I praise him and I love him.
Yeah.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Praise the Lord. That's right. Amen. Praise the Lord. Somebody else. Amen. Yes, it will. Amen.
Praise
him. It is the children ready to go to children's church. Okay. Praise the Lord. All right. Let's all stand while they're going to go. And I want you to turn your Bibles to Genesis chapter 3 with me. And let's look in Genesis chapter 3 and let's look at a few verses of scripture there. And this is one of them mornings when I had everything down that I was going to say and I was going to preach, and but God said, nope, we're going to do something new. Say amen. So, amen. So we're just going to obey the Lord. Amen. And we're just going to obey him. Amen. Because we want to be in his perfect will. And God puts the word on our hearts, and there's somebody that needs it. I need it. Amen. Let's look in Genesis chapter 3 and let's look at verse 1. Now the Bible says the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made. And he said unto the woman, yea, hath God said, you shall not eat of every tree of the garden. And the woman said unto the serpent, we may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden, but of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God has said, you shall not eat of it, neither shall ye touch it, lest you die. And the serpent said unto the woman, you shall not surely die, for God doth know that in the day that you eat thereof, then your eyes shall be opened, and you shall be as gods, that's a little g, knowing good and evil. And when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was pleasant to the eyes, a tree to be desired to make one wise, she took of the fruit thereof, and did eat, and gave also unto her husband with her, and he did eat. And the eyes of both of them were opened, and they knew that they were naked, and they sewed fig leaves together, and made themselves aprons. And they heard the voice of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And Adam and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God amongst the tree of the garden. And the Lord God called unto Adam and said unto him, where art thou? And he said, I heard thy voice in the garden, I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself. And God said, who told thee that thou wast naked? Hast thou eaten of the tree whereof I commanded thee that thou shouldest not eat? And the man said, the woman whom thou gavest to me to be with me, she gave me of the tree, and I did eat. And the Lord God said unto the woman, what is this that thou hast done? God asked a question. What is this that thou hast done? And the woman said, the serpent beguiled me, and I did eat. If you go over in Genesis chapter 3 and verse 24. So he drove out the man and placed them in place at east of the Garden of Eden, cherubims and a flaming sword which turned every way to keep the way of the tree of life. Let's pray. Lord, Father, we love you today, and Lord, we see in these verses the fall of man. We see the tool of the enemy today. As the tool of Satan came, and we know the Bible says that he's transformed himself into an angel of light today. But he deceived man. Lord, you gave man a free will choice. And their choice was that they ate of the fruit that you had forbidden them not to eat of. The consequences because of this was you thrust them out of the garden. And Lord, from generations from Adam, we're all suffering from the curse of sin. But I'm so thankful that you gave us your Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. He broke that curse. He's our Redeemer. Everything that we were sold out to through Jesus Christ, we were bought back. And now, through salvation by faith, we can have the forgiveness of sins, and we can enter another relationship with you, Lord. God, I thank you for that. God, would you give us wisdom and knowledge, Father, today? God, just help us. God, just to be still, and God, hear from you today. And I pray, God, that may through the Holy Spirit, the inspiration of God, I pray that, God, the enemy would be exposed today. In Jesus' name, amen. You can be seated, amen. Well, we live in America. Thank God America is a place of a home, a place of the free. Thank God for the freedom that we have today, somebody didn't stand over me with a gun and said I couldn't come to church, but we still have the freedom to come and worship the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. So I thank God for that. As we look at these verses of Scripture here, they're very familiar. Probably some of the first Scriptures that you ever heard, because it's the beginning of the Bible. And the Bible says that God made man in His image and in His likeness. Why did God make man to start with? God made us for fellowship. Amen. God wanted a relationship with man. So He created man. He created Adam and He created Eve. And you know what? He said it's good. Amen. Here in Genesis chapter 3, we see here that the Bible says that the serpent, which we would think of as a snake or whatever, the Bible never says that. But let me just say this. In Isaiah chapter 14, we see the fall of Lucifer. Let's turn there to the Scriptures. Isaiah chapter 14, and let's look at verses 12 through 15. The Bible says, "How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning? How art thou cast down to the ground, which didst weaken the nations? For thou hast said in thine heart, I will ascend into heaven. I will exalt my throne above the stars of God. I will sit also upon the mount of the congregation in the sides of the north. And I will ascend above the heights of the clouds, and I will be like the Most High. Yet thou shalt be brought down to hell, to the sides of the pit." Here was Lucifer, which was in heaven. He made a decision that he would exalt his throne above God's throne. How many of you know there's none supreme to God?
That's right.
God always has been, and He always will be. He's Alpha and Omega. Let me just say that Satan was cast down from heaven. And the angels under him. And the Bible says that hell was prepared for him. Not for man, but was prepared for the fallen angels. And that was Lucifer. And here we see in Genesis chapter 3 that Satan has popped up. And the Bible says he came in the form of a serpent. The Bible says he was more subtle than any beast of the field.
Yep.
In other words, he was most beautiful. I mean, when you seen this serpent, I mean, wow. This was something to look at. Today we have a picture of what we think Satan looks like on the can of a red devil eye or whatever, with a pitchfork and two horns that stick up, and he's red and he's got a long tail. Friends, that's not what Satan looks like at all.
Right.
Amen. How many of you know the Bible says that Satan has transformed himself into an angel of light? He's most beautiful today. He had to have been, because here Adam and Eve had a relationship with God. It was in a perfect relationship. They had perfect union with God. And I believe, as the Bible says, that God came in the cool of the day, that He would come and He would walk and talk with Adam and Eve, and He would have a conversation with them.
Yep, He would.
But this one day God showed up, and it was different. The Bible says that the serpent, in verse 1, was more subtle than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made. And he said unto the woman, number one, Satan questioned the word of God. Amen. 2 Corinthians chapter 11 and verse 14. And no marvel, for Satan himself has transformed himself into an angel of light.
Yeah.
You know, there's been a lot of talk today about sin and about problems of the world. Friends, our problem do not stem from Washington, D.C.
That's right.
It does not stem from our local government or our state government. The problem is sin.
Yeah.
Why do you and I struggle every day to serve God? Because sin. The Bible says that we can't serve God in the flesh.
Right.
And here in Genesis chapter 3 and verse 1 here, Satan came on the scene. And if you look with me in Genesis chapter 2, verses 16 and 17. Now here was what the Word of God said.
Yeah,
amen.
Right.
And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden thou mayest freely eat. Verse 17, God said, but of the tree of knowledge of good and evil, thou shalt not eat of it. For in the day that thou eatest thereof, thou shalt surely die.
Yeah.
Now that's what God said. You know what Satan's doing today? He's changing the Word of God. Satan's goal in verse 1 was to deceive and to sow doubt in Eve's mind.
Yeah.
And how many of you know the devil's doing that today?
Right. Yeah.
The devil has changed the Word of God.
Great.
Well, it's not that bad. Let me say, friends, sin is sin.
That's right.
Amen. There's no way around that. Amen. Bible says to a man, sin that doeth not, sin is, I'm trying to get it out of the kingdom. Him that knoweth to do good and doeth not, to him it is sin. Sin is an unrighteousness to God. But here, Satan has deceived, and that's exactly to what he did to Eve. In other words, he changed the way Eve thought, did she not?
That's right.
He changed the way that Eve thought because Eve heard the Word of God. Adam and Eve heard the Word in verse 16 and 17, thou mayest eat of every tree in the garden, freely eat of it.
Yeah.
But here, Satan's goal was to deceive and to sow doubt in Eve's mind. How many of you know that Satan today, he challenges the authorship of God's Word?
Right.
You know what Satan said? Yea, hath God said. Yeah, God said. Amen.
Right.
Let me say, friends, we got to take the Word of God for what it says. Amen.
Yep.
But yet Satan says, yea, hath God said. So in other words, he sowed doubt. And he sowed deception in Eve's mind. Notice what it says here. Yea, hath God said, you shall not eat of every tree of the garden. Well, it won't hurt to do this a little bit. It won't hurt to go there. I mean, look. You need to have some fun. Yea, have God said. Satan is alive and well today. And he's sowing doubt and deception in people's minds today, even church people, amen?
That's right, come on.
But today, to a sinner, here's what the devil would say. Well, just go on down there to church. Just go on to church. See, you can even give some money. Or you can even clean up the church. You can even mow the grass. You can even do all these things. Sit on the front row of the church. Dress up in a suit. It'll be okay. Actually, go to the elder's house and help her. Satan will tell you to do all these things. But there's one thing he won't tell you to do, and that's to receive the Lord Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior.
Yeah.
Amen.
Right.
He challenged the authorship of God's Word. Yea, hath God said.
Yeah.
Not only that, but he challenges the accuracy of God's Word.
That's right. He sure does.
Let me say, friends, today that this Word is the bestseller year after year. Let me just say that. Why do you think we struggle so much with it? Not getting in it and not reading it and not taking the Word of God for what it says. Because the devil don't want you to. He wants you to do everything else but read this.
Yeah.
Amen. But you see, this Word in Psalms, it says that it's settled in heaven.
Yes.
God put His seal of approval upon His Word. And it's settled in heaven. But there's idiots out there today, and I'll say idiots because that's exactly what they are. They're the change. Really, yea, have God said. This Word right here is full of power.
Amen.
In God's wisdom. Did you know that nowhere in these 66 books in this Bible does it contradict one place to another? Look at the four Gospels. Those were men that were followers of Jesus. They may have seen it in a little different view, but it never contradicted one another. There's power in God's Word.
Amen.
The Word of God can prick a person's heart. You can come under conviction of your sins through God's Word.
Amen. That's right.
The Bible says that where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty and there's freedom. Yeah. That's what we pray for every Sunday when we come to the house of God. We pray that there'll be freedom and liberty for the Holy Spirit to work and to show us our hearts and to show us our lives.
Yeah.
Did you know that just in a short time that God was revealing this to me this morning, that God not only revealed this, but He showed me myself.
Oh.
It was like the mirror. The Word of God was a mirror.
Yeah.
And it was showing me. It was showing my very self. See, it's for instructions. Amen. That the man of God may be thoroughly and perfectly furnished. Amen. That's what God's Word does. God shows us ourselves. And I had to fall on my knees and say, Lord, forgive me.
Yeah. Oh.
Cleanse me.
Great.
Because, Lord, I failed you. Mm-hmm. Notice what it says here. Not only does he challenge the accuracy of God's Word, but he said, yea, have God said, you shall not eat of every tree of the garden. Well, let's go back to verse 17. Verse 16, and the Lord God commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden thou mayest freely eat. Verse 17, but of the tree of knowledge of the tree of good and evil, thou shalt not eat of it.
Right.
That's what God's saying.
Yep.
But Satan said, and you shall freely eat. In other words, notice Satan is really saying, is it really fair? Notice this. Satan is, and he's sowing deep doubt in Eve's mind this whole time. Could you just hear Satan saying, really? Really, is this fair? That God has prohibited your eating from every tree? Is that really fair? Is that really fair? That God would tell you to do something like that? Or that sounds just like the subtle one, Satan, don't it? Did you know Satan is telling lies today? Those same lies. He's telling that teenager, it's okay. It's okay to step out. And try sex before you get married. It's okay. Let me say, friends, that's a lie from Satan.
Yes.
That's a lie from the enemy. Friends, let me say this. That God made a boundary there, and that boundary was marriage. Amen. Satan also takes away from God's word. The word freely. Did you know that even Satan in Matthew chapter 4, verses 1 through 11, even Satan came and used his same tactic towards Jesus.
Yeah.
And you know what Jesus did? He used the word.
Sure did.
He used the word of God. Let me say that today you say, Satan is attacking me. You know the only way that you're going to set the devil running is the word of God. Amen.
Yeah.
Not Satan, get out of here and leave me alone. That don't bother him. But what bothers Satan is the blood of Jesus.
Yeah.
He knows that through Christ he's been defeated.
Amen.
Amen. But notice what he says here. He says, yea, have God said, you shall not eat of every tree of the garden. And the woman said unto the serpent, we may eat of every fruit of the trees of the garden. Now, this whole time, Satan has planted this seed in Eve's mind.
Yep.
And let me tell you how it's affected her already. Verse 3. The Bible says, but of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God has said, you shall not eat of it, neither shall you touch it, lest you die. Wrong. Because God never said anything about touching it, did he? Notice what the scripture says. God said, but of the tree of knowledge, of the tree of good and evil, thou shalt not eat of it. For in the day that thou eatest thereof, thou shalt surely die. And yet, it was planted in Eve's mind that we should not only eat of it, but we should not even touch it. I'm going to say this. I'm no match to Satan, but there's one that's living inside of me that is.
Amen.
Amen. Because Satan has 6,000 years experience. Amen. Mm-hmm. And I'm no match to him. But I tell you what, through the Lord Jesus Christ, I can say, devil, flee.
Yep.
The Bible says that we should submit ourselves, therefore, to God and resist the devil. And the Bible says that he'll flee.
Amen.
Amen.
Right.
Satan takes away from God's word, the word freely. Not only does Satan question the Word of God, but I mean, I know that sin has a penalty.
Yep.
Because God said in verse 17 of Genesis 2, He says, "For thou shalt not eat of it, for in the day that thou eatest thereof, thou shalt surely die." That's what God said. God said, "You're going to die." Did you know man had not experienced death? There was a perfect union between God and man. It was paradise, was it not? Everything was perfect. No storms, no earthquakes, no sickness, no pain, no diseases, because it was paradise. Everything was perfect. Because this was a setting that God had made to have fellowship with man. Notice what the Bible says in verse 4. "And the serpent said unto the woman, ye shall not surely die." That's a very bold statement from Satan, ain't it? That's a very bold statement from Satan. "Ye shall not surely die." But verse 17, he says, "In the day that you eat thereof, ye shall die." So you would think, well, you know, God said that you're going to die, so I'm not going to believe Him. Look at here. I'm trying to help you for a minute. I'm not going to believe Him, but here, Satan had got so much influence. Let me say this. He became so much of an influence to Eve that she actually was going to believe this. Let me say this, friends, that Satan has come to do three different things, and that is to steal and to kill and to destroy.
Yeah, yeah.
Satan is a liar. There is no truth in him.
Man.
If it don't lift up God, it's a lie.
Right.
You hear people say, "Well, I have a question about whether to do this or not." You better not do it. Amen.
Yeah.
But he had even got to the point that he says, "You shall not surely die." But he says, verse 5, he says, "For God doth know that in the day that you eat thereof, that your eyes shall be opened. That your eyes shall be opened, and you shall be as gods, knowing good and evil." Now that's not a big G on gods, is it? That's a little G. Let me say, friends, there's many gods in this world.
Yeah.
And around the world. But there's only one capital G.
Yeah.
God, amen?
Yeah.
And He's in heaven, and His Son is on the right hand of the Father, and His Holy Spirit lives in believers today, amen?
Right.
And here, Satan has convinced Eve that it will be okay to take something that God has forbidden not to do. Because in all reality, you'll be able to know the very mind of God. That's exactly what the devil was saying. Friends, do you know the very mind of God? No, I don't either. The Bible says in Isaiah that my ways are not God's ways.
Right.
Neither are our thoughts His thoughts. But it says that His ways and His thoughts are much higher than ours.
Yeah.
But yet here Satan has so much influence that he has convinced Eve that you'll be as gods. That you'll be able to know good from evil. You see how Satan he didn't just come out and say, "Just eat that fruit. God's a liar. Just eat that fruit." No, that ain't what Satan said at all. But he convinced her. And that's what Satan is doing today. A lot of believers, even in our churches today, I believe why we can't see revival and can't see God really move is because the devil has influenced people. That we live in a time where God can't move. Friends, that's a lie from Satan. Amen.
Yeah,
my God hasn't changed.
That's right.
I serve a big God. Amen.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
If God could send a revival to the Wells community, God could do it today. Amen. But yet God is, the devil has placed doubt into believers' minds today. Let me say this. My God's a great physician.
Amen.
Let me say there's nothing that my God can't do.
That's right.
My God's bigger than any drug that anybody could ever put in their system.
Yeah.
In other words, my God is big enough that if you are an addict, that you can be delivered from that. Amen.
Right.
Through a holy and righteous God. Amen.
Right.
I'm not going to limit God today. And don't you limit God. Amen.
Right.
You say, preacher, I come from a bad background. You don't understand. I do. How many of you know God can deliver that? Amen.
Amen.
Greater is He that is in us than he that's in the world. Friends, I'm nothing today. I'm just an old sinner saved by the grace of God. Amen.
Amen.
You ever told me that I'd be up in front of a congregation preaching to a bunch of people, I'd say, you were crazy, amen. But see, God has a sense of humor, don't he, amen? God has a plan, not only for me, but for you. And you know who's wanting to disrupt it today? Satan. He's wanting to disrupt what God wants to do. I'm going to tell you what, God wants to do some things here in this church. Right here in this local assembly. I believe God wants to do some great things. But I tell you what, Satan has sowed in our minds a seed of doubt.
Yeah.
Well, it won't ever happen. We can't get that money up. Or we won't ever be able to do that. That's a seed of doubt that Satan throws in. Look. My God owns it all. Amen.
Amen.
But notice, if you think about it, and there's been some questions, says, why didn't Satan come to Adam? Amen. Why did he come to Eve? Maybe because God commanded Adam. But yet Adam and Eve were still inseparable, was they not? They were. They were still inseparable. But yet God chose to come to Eve. It's something to think about, ain't it? The Bible says the woman is the weaker vessel, but that would be in the days of sin, right? Not actually in when man had not sinned. But did God not directly speak His commands to Adam? I believe that's why the devil didn't come to Adam. Because God spoke His commands directly to Adam and not Eve. Let me say that Satan will use any tool, any avenue, to get you away from God.
That's right.
He'll use any tool, any avenue to keep a sinner from coming to know the Lord Jesus Christ.
Right.
Amen. You believe that? Yes. I believe that.
Yep.
Amen. Well, just turn over a new leaf. Well, let's take one of these do better pills under here. We take that do better pill. I know I'm going to do better. Won't work. Only through Jesus.
Amen.
Only can we have deliverance from the curse through the Lord Jesus Christ.
Right.
Satan influenced within the human affairs so that He is called the God and the Prince of this world. Because of this day, did you know that the Bible says that Satan is the God of this world? That he's transformed himself into an angel of light. That he could deceive man. It separated. You know what this very decision did? In verse 6, the Bible says, "And when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was pleasant to the eyes, a tree to be desired to make one wise, that she took of the fruit thereof, and did eat, and gave also unto her husband with her, and he did eat." And the Bible says in verse 7, that the eyes of both of them were open. And they knew that they were naked, and they sewed fig leaves together, and made themselves aprons. Did you know that this very decision that Adam and Eve made, that it separated them from God? And that's what sin does today. Sin separates us from God. The Bible says in Romans 5:12, "Wherefore, as by one man, sin entered into the world, and death by sin." So that sin has passed down through all generations.
Yep.
Did you know that that's the problem from this time forward? Is sin. We have a sin problem. Preacher, why? Why can't I be faithful to God? Why can't I be like so-and-so? Why can't I be spiritual? Why can't I? Because of sin. Sin has wreaked havoc upon our world. Sickness, pain, death, all these things are consequences from sin. And the Bible says that immediately after they did that, that they perceived that they were naked and they hid themselves from God. You know what sin will do? Sin will make you hide from God.
That's right.
I'm talking to a believer right now. Sin will make you ashamed, especially if you're a believer. Sin will cause you to lose that fellowship that you had with God.
Right.
Could you imagine the pain that Adam and Eve was feeling? Because here they were in perfect union with God. And for this first time, they realized that something was wrong. And it says that they went and they hid themselves. And the first thing they did, they sewed fig leaves together to try to hide themselves, their nakedness from God.
Yeah.
Let me just say this, and I'm going to close right here. Verse 8, he says, "And they heard the voice of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cooler day. And Adam and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God amongst the trees of the garden." They hid themselves. "And the Lord called unto Adam and said unto him, Where art thou?" That's kind of strange. God called and said, "Where art thou?" God knew where they were. How many of you know God knows where we're at today? God knows you, and God knows me. You won't fool the preacher. You won't fool your spouse. You won't fool them, but God knows. Let me beg you this morning to come clean with God. Amen? If you've been playing church, please don't do it anymore. Greatest decision that a person will ever make is to follow Jesus.
Yeah.
And say, "Lord, save me."
Right.
But you may be here today and you may have lost that fellowship. I mean, you're miserable. You're just downright miserable. Because you have listened to the lies of Satan. And let me say this. I want you to look with me in verse 15. Verse 14. And the Lord God said unto the serpent, because thou hast done this, thou art cursed above all cattle and above every beast of the field. Upon the belly shalt thou go, and dust shalt thou eat all the days of thy life. And verse 15. God said, I will put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed, and it shall bruise thy head, and thou shalt bruise his heel. The whole time when this happened, God was coming up with a redemption plan for man.
Yep.
God was looking for a way that he could restore fellowship between man and him. Amen. That's a merciful God, amen. Yeah. That is a merciful God.
Yes, sir.
But on the cross, the Lord Jesus, how many of you know he conquered this power of Satan over individual human hearts? In 1 Corinthians 15, verses 56 and 57, Jesus took those keys of death and hell. But Satan today is still in the office today.
Yep.
He's still in the office today because his time is not yet come. But one day, the Lord will take away his kingdom. How many of you know that? And his rule over the earth. The Bible says he's the God of this world.
Right.
Satan. And we talk about it today, the demonic possession.
Yep.
And we see it. I mean, Satan is influencing people to do evil things. And until Jesus puts him in his place, he's going to continue to do it.
That's right. Yep.
Amen.
Yes.
He's going to continue to do it. But how many of you know God had a plan? There was one that would come to abolish the works of Satan. Satan's tool is cursed, and a Savior is promised in verse 15. Let me say this, and I'm going to close right here. A woman, here was God's promise in verse 15, that a woman would have a son. How many of you know her name was Mary? And she would have a son. And that son would destroy Satan.
Amen.
And we have the sure promise of the destruction of Christ's death and resurrection through Satan is still active. However, Revelation chapter 20 and verse 10. Let me read it to you. Revelation chapter 20. In verse 10, the Bible says, and the devil that deceived them was cast into the lake of fire and brimstone, where the beast and the false prophets are, and shall be tormented day and night forever and ever. That day hasn't came yet, but it's coming. That Satan will be destroyed. But notice here, Satan would bruise the heel of the woman's son. And that came about when Jesus went to the cross. Not that he took his life, but Satan bruised the heel of this woman's son, Christ's body, but not his mind and his soul. But he was bruised on the cross. But Jesus said this. He said, no man took my life from me, but I laid it down freely. and I have power to take it again. That's where the scripture says in Romans 5:8, but God commanded his love toward us, and that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Jesus became sin for us. He took upon himself the curse of sin in his own body. Amen. Stand to your feet this morning. Here's what I want us to realize this morning, that the enemy is working overtime. Satan's working overtime. And his job is to deceive man, is to deceive us. And you know, even some of the works of Satan can deceive the very elect of God. But let me say this morning that the devil's a liar. And there's no truth in him. Life is very fragile, ain't it? And life is short. The Bible says life is like a vapor. It's here and then it's gone. But aren't you thankful that God has put you in his plan? Amen. And here we are today in God's plan. And God is using you and I to change the world. We can. Did you know that there was two elderly women began to pray and they began to seek God for revival? Seek God for revival. Seek God to move and change. Did you know that God honored their prayer? There's power in prayer. Every head bowed, every eye closed. This morning, give reverence to God this morning. The devil's a liar. And there's no truth in him. But yet, he is the God of this world. He has influenced this world. And we see the works of Satan. We see the destruction of Satan all across the world, all across America today. And I thank God there's one that's a deliverer, and that's the Lord Jesus Christ. While the song's being played this morning, I want us to do inventory with the Lord. How is it with you? Have you been playing church? Are you saved? How is your relationship with God? This is your invitation this morning.
Time
played and I can see. I cried some bitter tears, but I felt his arms around me as I faced my greatest fears. You see, I've had more gain and losses. Have I known more joy than hurt? And as his grace rolled down upon me, so I deserve.
Yes,
God's good in my go to sleep each night. Sure, I've had my share of hard times. I wouldn't change them if I could. Through it all, God's been good. God has been my Father, my Savior, and my friend. And his love will be my end. I am ever, ever trying to tell you everything he is. The best way I can tell you, God's been good. I've been blessed beyond all out of here. Sure, we've had our share of hard times. I wouldn't change them if I could. Through it all, through it all, God, you've sure been good.
Praise the Lord. Amen. God is good. Amen. Thank you, brother. Appreciate that. Thank you for being here today, and thank God for what he did. Amen. God touched my heart. Amen. And let me see how real the enemy is. And we need to be aware. The Bible says that in Ephesians chapter 6, to put on the whole armor of God, that we can withstand the fiery darts from the wicked one. Amen. And I hope that you will use that. The Bible says that our weapons, they're not carnal, but they're mighty through God. Amen. Pulling down his strongholds. Thank God. All right, Michelle.
We have prayer cards up front. If you have a prayer request, fill out the card, put it in the box. Prayer warriors pray for those on Wednesday nights. The missions jar up front on the table. Anything you put in that jar supports our 10 missionaries that we have. Also, the baby bottles are due back today. If you have a bottle that's full or not full or whatever, if you haven't turned it in, please be sure to bring that back tonight, because we need to turn those in tomorrow. And we have to have all the bottles, because if not, we have to pay for each bottle that's not turned in. And I just want to thank everybody that's participated in that. It looked like we had a good turnout, so I thank y'all for that. Tonight, come back at 6 o'clock for Bible study. We also have finger foods tonight. This coming Friday, the 10th, the King's Kids going to be having a movie night from 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. So be sure to bring the King's Kids out for that to have a good time. And then next Sunday, the 12th, we're going to have a baptism and ordination service. That will be during the evening service. So come out and support that as well. On the 19th, we're having a monthly meal. And then February 25th is going to be a Saturday. That's our ladies' meeting. We're going to have that at Sunshine Nutrition at 9 a.m. We're going to be doing Zumba. Ladies, it's $5 per person. So I pray that y'all can come out and be a part of that. And then lastly, February 26th, or next to the last, February 26th, we're going to be getting our bake sale. All proceeds raised from that will go to the Pregnancy Resource Center's Wall for Life. And then lastly is the Operation Christmas Child shoeboxes. The item that we're collecting this month is bar soap.
Amen.
Bar practice last week.
What?
5 minutes to five.
Bar practice.
Bar practice.
Those of you who are getting baptized if you're here today, if you know somebody in your family that's getting baptized, three or four people, please be here 30 minutes early next Sunday night so we can talk to you about the baptism.
You notice on the Wednesday service at 7 o'clock, is this o'clock?
It is Wednesday at 7, yeah.
It's just Sunday night.
You just hung around. You left too soon. Praise the Lord.
Hey, good Lord, still blessed.
That's right. Yeah.
Hey, you put an effort there, didn't you,
brother? That's right.
Praise the Lord. You prayed for us before we got here, didn't you? Amen. All right. There you go. Praise the Lord. All right. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Landon, will you close us out in prayer?
Dear Heavenly Father, Lord God, thank you for allowing us to be here today. Lord, just thank you for the word. Lord, just bless us as we walk out the door, Lord. Be God and breakfast.